A fossil hey from CFA. What's up, guys? Ash Begale here, owner of Charleston Fossil Adventures and photographer and co-author of A Beachcomber's Guide to Fossils. So you're in Charleston, you want to find some shark teeth, and you came to the right place. In this video, we're going to go over how to find shark teeth right here in Charleston. So let's go on out and see all the amazing things that we can find. Literally the first tooth that we came upon sitting right down here on the beach. Check out this gorgeous blade from an 18 to 30 million year old ancestor of the megalodon shark. This one is going to be either from Carcharocles chubutensis or angustidens. So a sign of good finds to come for today. One very important thing when you're out looking for shark teeth is that they're not always going to be right out in the open like that first one we found. This one has recently been uncovered by the waves, and so this is literally all we see sticking out. It's a little bit of the root, a little bit of that enamel crown. Let's see how much is actually there. All right. Oh, yes, we got both cusplets and both root lobes. That is a beautiful little tooth from Carcharocles chubutensis, which is that 18 to 24 million year old father, direct ancestor of megalodon. What a great way to start the day. Not everything out here is a shark tooth. This one is a beautiful tooth from a cow nose stingray, and it's actually complete. We can see these two little pointed ends on the left and right where the lateral teeth articulate with this middle tooth. It's actually grinding and chewing with this flat surface, and the things that look like teeth are actually the root that go into the actual jaw of the ray. Check this thing out. So this, while it's not black, it is still a fossil. This is a chunk of fossilized ivory from the tusk of a mammoth and mastodon. And the part that can tell us that so clearly is right there. Look at those gorgeous Strieger lines. These are the bands of how dentine grows outward in the tusk of elephants, mammoths, mastodons, four-tusked elephants. Beautiful fossil here from the Ice Age, likely around 100,000 years old. I know this one looks especially like a rock. However, if we flip this over, we can see a pretty distinct pattern on the inside. This one is a tympanic bulla, which is one of the two harder ear bones within the skull of a small baleen whale. So here's something pretty cool. We got half of the corner of a root from a megalodon. That sucker would have easily been about 4 inches long minimum. It's always fun to uncover these and see if the whole blade is sticking down into the sand. Look at that gorgeous blade, most likely from a chubutensis or an angustidens. We got another just sitting right out in the open here. Beautiful little juvenile tooth from the megalodon family. His cusplets are knocked off, so it's hard to tell what member of the lineage he belongs to. And then looks like right over here, we have a tooth from Alopius vulpinus, a thresher shark tooth there. Gorgeous bicolor preservation there on the root and the crown. Oh, wait, 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 wait. There we go, right over here. Half of a chubutensis right there as well. Not bad for a, oh, and a stingray tooth right there. Not bad for a little 2 foot square area. Of course, we love a good Ice Age fossil out here, and we actually almost dismissed this as a piece of oyster phosphate. But flipping this sucker over, we can see, wow, a gorgeous loaf of enamel
from what would have been probably around an 8-inch long American mastodon tooth. So another one of our 100,000-year-old Ice Age fossils. Beautiful diagonal banding running up the interior of that enamel. One of the really easy ways to identify this out on the beach. Wrinkled on the outside, we got smooth on the inside, and that enamel itself is about 5 millimeters or 1/4 inch thick. Some of the thickest tooth enamel we can find from any animal from the Ice Age. You take a look right there at that chewing surface. We've got a section of a giant capybara molar from the Ice Age. So the world's largest rodent was even larger during the Ice Age. And this was one of its continuously growing teeth because rodents' teeth don't have roots. They grow continuously as they're grinding down all of their food. Beautiful piece right here. Some of the thinnest tooth enamel that we will see on our Ice Age megafauna's teeth. All right, beautiful mako shark tooth right there from either Icerus retroflexus, which might be a junior synonym for Icerus palcus, which is one of our current mako shark teeth, based on how flat this crown is. And I believe we got some other stuff right over here. Whoa, yeah. All right, so we got a beautiful Ice Age fossil right here. This is the medial phalanx, or the middle toe bone, essentially this part of our finger from a horse that lived here, oh wow, in the Ice Age. That's one of the most beautiful ones I've ever seen. You can see the articular surface of the proximal phalanx and then the ungual phalanx right here, which would be the quote unquote hoof core. So horses are essentially standing on their middle fingers, their ancestral bone structure of having multiple digits transitioning from a soft forest floor to harder grasslands. They didn't need extra toes supporting their weight on the ground. So that's why they went down from 4- and 5-toed to 3-toed and ultimately single-toed horses like we have today. All right, we also have a corner of a very beautiful megalodon tooth right here and a potential horse tooth hiding right here next to this rock. To go with our medial phalanx, we have a lower cheek tooth from a horse. And yet another thing right over here. Look at this gorgeous mako shark tooth just sitting right on top of the beach. Wow, absolutely gorgeous upper anterior tooth from Icerus oxyrhynchus. So this is a pretty cool fossil right here. We have what's called a marginal bone from the extinct sea turtle, Carolina keeleys. This one being from the edge of the shell. We can see that nice thin edge right there. And if we look on what's called the proximal end, the interior of the bone, we can see that little socket where the end of the rib that makes up the top shell of the sea turtle articulates into all of the ones on the edge of the shell. Another great way we can identify sea turtle bone out here is through the smooth flat surface on the dorsal side, so the top, smooth flat surface on the ventral side, the bottom. And if it's broken like this one is, we can actually see spongy bone on the inside. So it's like an Oreo cookie. You got two solid parts and you have a filling in between. And so all of that is our cancellous spongy bone. And then on the other side, we actually have the sutures of the complete bone where that bone joined with another to make up the turtle's shell. Now, another important thing about fossil hunting is slowing down and taking your time. I know it's incredibly tempting to run around all over the place like a squirrel trying to find all of the big teeth sitting right on top. However, if you slow down and take your time, you can find teeth like the two that are on either side of me right here. First off, we're going to take a look at this member of the megalodon lineage. Beautiful little, let's see. Most likely an angustidens with that cusplet well-defined from the crown. And then right over here, a rarer tooth to find here in Charleston from the Miocene, about 18 million years old. we've got a giant thresher tooth here of an absolute giant, giant thresher. Awesome sickle-shaped tooth and sickle-shaped root. Not bad for 3 feet apart. We had another really nice one over here. Check this sucker out. Just partially exposed. Let's check the crown first. We've got a crown. Check the root. We have a root. We have a root. Absolutely gorgeous. Probably late angustidons, maybe early chubby tensis. Little bit of that cusplet nicked off there on the distal edge, but still, the fact that this thing has been around for about 30 million years, it's an incredible fossil. Always an amazing feeling to hold this piece of our prehistoric past. We're out here at a locality that has a lot of Miocene age material, so kind of 18 million years ago. However, we do have older material, like we mentioned, upwards of 30 million years old. And one of the things that we just found is this little guy right here. So this is a periodic, one of the two ear bones from a toothed dolphin from the group called Wypatiids. So they're this extinct spear-toothed dolphin lineage that had big cagey incisors that kind of hung out the front of their mouth. You can think of it a lot like a show, a display show, like antlers on a deer. This ear bone is incredibly diagnostic. It has all of these little semicircular canals you can see inside the cochlea there. The tightness of the spiral, the diameter, the number of turns these make, all tell us a lot of really cool facts about early evolution of echolocating in dolphins. So just a single bone here can tell us more than we would ever hope to know about this species if we had just found, you know, like a little finger bone or a vertebra from it. So always cool to find these and always worth keeping your eye out for this unusually shaped bone. One other feature that we can see about this, it's relatively smooth right here on this side, but then when we look over here, we can see it's pretty dimpled. Apparently, this can tell us that this belongs to a juvenile. So this probably was a subadult growing into a biological adult, but in the juveniles, we have all that little kind of texturing on the outside of the bone. So check this thing out. Right here, we've got a beautiful vertebra from a tuna. This thing is just absolutely preserved perfectly. Couldn't have asked for better preservation on this. One of the things that I absolutely love about Charleston is the fact that our fossils really have received little tumbling around both pre and post fossilization, giving us such exceptional preservation like this. We can tell it is a fish, of course, because of these funnel or hourglass shaped articular surfaces. That hollowness to the vertebra allows the fish to have greater flexibility to the spine, enabling it to swim a heck of a lot faster than if these vertebrae were solid and flat on each end. Beautiful, beautiful find. Got something pretty cool right here that a lot of collectors would have simply just walked over. This thing is a fulgurite. It is where lightning has struck the beach, struck the sand. You can see it has solidified. This little part right here, we can see this kind of creamy, smooth interior. And then we have all of this rough exterior sand and rock kind of glued on to that fused sand. And because this island is chock full of fossils, what's really cool is we've got a sand tiger tooth that was embedded within this quote unquote fossilized lightning event. So pretty cool. It's one of the only places here in Charleston we've found that these occur. And we might even have a little piece of a ray tooth or some other tooth embedded in that section as well. Easy to get super fixated on those big triangles, but we also have some slender teeth out here on the beach. Most notable within that category, of course, is going to be the mako sharks and this one, which looks like it's going to be a lateral tooth from the extinct great white shark, Carcharodon histalis. No serrations on the edge, a little bit more of a squared off rectangular root, whereas those makos would have more longer pointed root lobes, even on their upper teeth. So another beautiful tooth from today's trip. So look at that. This one is going to be a massive vertebra, most likely a tiger shark on this one based on size and these ovoids on the dorsal and ventral sides. These are foramina that supply nutrients into the center of the vertebra. They are a less dense cartilage than the calcified cartilage of the main centrum. Technically, these are centrum instead of vertebrae. Due to its size and some of those features, we can tell going to belong to a tiger shark. Now, a lot of people often note the rings on the inside here, and they ask us, can you tell how old the shark is based on those rings? And the short answer is, it depends. You have to know the species of shark, because some sharks will deposit sometimes up to 4 rings per year. So isolated ones like this, a little harder to tell, but still a fantastic find. And yes, it is a fossil, just different sediments that preserve this one rather than our phosphate. So we have this circle where obviously someone was trying to help someone else find a shark tooth. We have this footprint right here, and then literally less than a foot out, we've got 3 teeth. Right here, there's this little guy, reef shark tooth. We've got one right here, a blade of an angustidons. And then let's see what we got here. All right, nice big blade, probably a chubutensis. Very cool. So another really cool thing we can find out here are specimens that show interactions between organisms prior to the fossilization process starting. So this little bone chunk right here comes from an extinct relative of our modern day manatees. It's incredibly dense bone. And what happened after this manatee died, his skeleton sunk down to the bottom of the ocean. We've got these pits right there. Those are from bone-eating worms that were working away at this as it lay exposed on the bottom of the ocean. But then we also have all of these little parallel lines. Sometimes these will be from sharks, but because these look like they're dragging across the surface of the bone, it is more likely that they are from a stingray that was trying to eat flesh that's still on the bone, or maybe even they're going after the bone-eating worms themselves. Similar to that piece of ivory we found, you have to keep your eye out for those fossils in other colors. And if we look right down here, we've got this gorgeous brown and blue enamel crown of this absolutely incredible snaggle tooth. Look at the preservation on that thing. This is going to lighten up as it dries out, really becoming a beautiful piece for a display case. If you want to find some amazing fossils just like this one, you can book an adventure with our team of paleontologists. Come out here in Charleston and find and keep a whole host of amazing fossils. All of that information to book is right down there, linked in the description. And as always, guys, happy hunting, collect responsibly, and we'll see you next time. Before we go, we actually found one other fossil out there on the beach. We're going to show it to you real quick. But would you look at that? I subscribe to Charleston Fossil Adventures on YouTube.